Almost 1 year ago, the creators of the breakthrough film Not Again, which spawned a major motion picture, 3 New York Times bestsellers, and an off-Broadway play which received 7 Tony nominations. Well, 1 year ago, these two young men began a journey that they would never forget.
Well, let me think. We originally made this movie somewhat as a joke, I guess. It was for a local film festival. We just sort of entered into it so the other people would have at least some sense of competition.
Yeah, but then when it played and we got that standing ovation, there was something there. I knew it and Chad knew it.
You're exactly right, Dave.
We felt it in our hearts.
It was like fate.
We knew there was going to be something big.
It was like a mistake that we were all really glad happened.
Like penicillin or Mount Dew Code Red. It's beautiful.
So a couple days after the festival, I get this call.
They called him.
Dude, that's because you were at Mystic Lake for like 4 days straight trying to win that big car or something.
Yeah, which I would have won if you wouldn't have had to come and drag me out of the casino.
Anyway, so this Hollywood producer gives us a call, and he's very, very interested in doing Not Again as a big-time Hollywood picture.
So we did.
And so they did. And by doing so, spawned one of the fastest-growing careers to hit Hollywood ever. And they got paid a holy crap load!
Hey, yeah, what's up? Woo-hoo! Yeah, you! Yeah, I know you! Yeah!
Jaguar, a Cadillac, I'll take one of those. Hey, how much for the whole day got, right?
The two were soon on magazine covers and in photo shoots nationwide.
I'm the king of the world.
Dude, we could eat at Burger King for the rest of our lives.
Dude, we wouldn't have to buy Kraft dinner anymore.
But we would eat Kraft dinner.
I know, we just buy more.
What's Kraft dinner?
I don't know.
But high times led to a fast fall. After their Van Heusen endorsement failed miserably, their popularity diminished faster than the Backstreet Boys fan club. Penniless and fanless, David sunk into a deep depression. Months of non-recognition take their toll on Dave's mental health. penniless and fanless, Chad sunk into a deep boredom. With all that has happened, Dave seeks solace in the supernatural.
Miss Cleo? Tell me my future? I don't want to be a loser all my life.
Call me now for your free reading! Okay, baby, what's your birthday?
February 3rd.
February 3rd. Well, don't you worry, baby, because Cleo's just going to shuffle the cards before she starts. And the cards, they lit, son of a...
What happened?
Nothing. Nothing happened at all. We're just going to get your future out of the way now.
Okay.
Well, I see here by the... Oh, my.
What?
You're pregnant, aren't you?
What?
Yeah, says right here that you're pregnant. You got the baby in the belly, don't you?
But I'm not pregnant.
Sure you ain't. Well, good luck with the baby. Can't tell you who the father is. Don't exactly know.
I'm not pregnant. I'm a man.
Yes, of course you are, my dear. We'll now take our next caller at this time. Excuse me, what's your birthday?
No, please help me. Okay, here, I'll tell you what.
After thousands of dollars in unpaid phone bills, a warrant for Dave's arrest locks him up for a week. Behind bars, he realized he needed to get his life back on track the only way he knew how. A sequel! Dave found Chad and pulled him out of his funk. And Not Again, Again was born. Seldom does a movie have the audacity to question its own genre. This movie will define cinema for years to come. The New York Times. If I had a third arm, I'd give it 3 thumbs up. I felt the, hey, a French fry! Roger Ebert, Chicago Sun-Times. This movie combines the passion of Temptation Island with the mystique of Temptation Island 2. Fox TV. Holy crap. Larry King. And now, we present the sequel to quite possibly the greatest movie of all time. Not Again, Again. Thank you.
Not again!
Real neat from our hearts to our feet.